further down that road, but I won't. No, seriously, I was, for many years, especially in Parliament, in Labour politics, I was a part of a consensus of which I'm now ashamed. I was a part of the consensus, despite having sat there under Margaret Thatcher, that said... That's her now. She's phoning from hell. Who knew? Who knew they had phones in the inferno? That consensus was that women equals good when it comes to children, and men equals maybe not so good. I was acutely aware, as we all are and have to acknowledge, there are tons of feckless fathers who've run away. Margaret, I'm busy. There are tons of feckless fathers, runaways, people that don't live up to their responsibilities, people who are poor fathers, poor parents. And I suppose that's where my state of knowledge lay. I was unmoved when my now good friend, very good friend Matt O'Connor, was climbing up on our building. In fact, in parenthesis, when I finally brought him into Parliament and about 50 police officers escorted us through the corridor, I could see that he was looking around spotting opportunities. And I had to ask him to cease and desist. But I was unmoved when Matt and his comrades were climbing up on various palaces and tall buildings. And then it happened to me. Then somebody else, I'm not really allowed to go into the details, but somebody else made a decision that my children were to be taken away from me. And even the promise, I loved that in the introduction, that I'll let you see the children, like it's some privilege, like you're some visiting uncle with money. When even that promise wasn't kept. I'll let you see the children anytime you want. It's you I'm leaving. It's not the children who are leaving. That's the kind of promise that was made, and I naively accepted it. And no sooner was I out the door when the locks were changed, and there was no longer a promise to let me see my children. Then we're in a court. Then we're in a court and a court and a court and a court and a court. And I've been in court tens of times. I have spent tens of thousands of pounds in court, which, by the grace of God, I was able to afford. But there'll be people here tonight, and there are certainly plenty out there, who, now that legal aid has been wiped from this field of the law, have no choice, as your earlier speaker had, but to be an applicant in person. Now, he'd be a very good one because he's very eloquent, but I've met many who are not good applicants in person, who are easily riled, who are easily frustrated enough to exhibit the very behavior that is bound to bring down the judge's hammer. I'm like you, I've won court orders, only for them not to be honored. The only courts in the country where you can defy a court order are family courts. And nobody can know about it, because the only courts in the country that are secret courts are the family courts. Justice must be done and must be seen to be done. That was the principle in English law since the Magna Carta, but not when it comes to our children. And whilst I could afford good lawyers, I too am on that never-ending treadmill. A never-ending treadmill, year after year after year after year. And so, of course, once it happened to me, I looked at Matt O'Connor in a different light. And then I realized that actually there are millions of people who should be looking to Matt O'Connor in a different light, whether they themselves are victims of the injustice against which he protests, or whether they just believe in justice, whether they just believe in equality. I tabled a motion in the Houses of Parliament asking for shared parenting. What could possibly be wrong with shared parenting? This child is as much yours as it is her mother's. Exactly as much. Not less because you're a man. Exactly as much. And she's certainly a lot more your child than she is the new boyfriend that's moved in and is now living with her, with access to her all the time. Nobody's checking his behavior. Nobody is running any kind of tests on him. He doesn't have to satisfy any judge for his permanent 24/7 access to your children. What could be just about that? And when I put the motion down, because Matt had told me by then the numbers of people affected by this issue, I expected the MP, especially as we're running up, I think, to a general election at that time. I expected the MPs to be flocking to sign it. But I hold the British record for tabling early day motions. I have tabled more motions in Parliament than any MP in history. That record still stands. But the one for shared parenting was the hardest work I have ever done. MPs would look down, look at the carpet, shuffle away, hide behind their order papers, pretend they were asleep. Some of them were dead, but they were still drawing their wages. And only when I managed to get on board the late and lamented former father of the House, my dear friend, may God rest his soul, Sir Gerald Kaufman, only when Gerald came on board did we make any progress at all. And in the end, we got a half-decent number,
104. And George, I can't remember, you said it was the grand national of early day motions.
Yes, it was. The Grand National fell at every fence. 104 MPs we got out of 650. And believe me, that was a triumph. Because for a long time, it looked like we wouldn't get 24. But we got 104. Then that parliament was dissolved and, well, I wish it was dissolved, but it was replaced by another. And I'm no longer there. And I don't know if anybody in the House of Commons now has the courage to take this matter up. Why do I say courage? Because the reason I only got 104 is because the MPs were frightened to sign it. Because if you sign it, you are then accused of everything from misogyny through boorishness to much worse. And that's a fundamental injustice. Because children need a father. Children need a father. A child is not a pawn to be played in a game. A child is not a weapon to punish somebody that their mother no longer likes. A mother is not automatically better than a father. And a mother and father together are far more important than the sum of their parts. So if the mother and father, for whatever reason, either because the wife leaves or the man leaves, if the mother and father cannot be together, then every effort, and the law should reflect this, every effort should be made